The inspiration really was from the kids. I was a technical teacher for about 20 years, teaching woodwork. And it was one of the kids themselves had said to me, "Mr. Thompson, why are you teaching us how to do hidden dovetails or mortise and tenon joints, traditional carpentry, when the chances are when we leave school, we're going to work in a factory?" And it struck a note with me. I thought I should really try and establish where more of these traditional skills are still being used. And I suppose the other thing was the kids themselves, because they showed a bit of interest in that, I then ran an extracurricular class with the kids, and we actually made a post and beam timber frame building. I was trying to encourage the kids themselves to look at other avenues of employment. Trained as an engineer, as a mechanical design engineer. Worked in Canada, worked in Australia. I was quite fortunate because of the skill set I had. I was able then to replicate and standardise a lot more design aspects. I suppose that was quite a useful skill to have. Occasionally we have clients who will say to us, you know, will I still have a view from my dining room window out to the sea, for example? And we have taken a scale model, superimposed it on site, digitally enhanced it to make it look like it was always there. And that sometimes has helped us clinch a deal. The skill set that you have coming from a teaching environment has certainly helped, plus the career, you know, being a technical illustrator, being an engineer, being computer literate, all these things have been all come together to allow us to get where we are. From my point of view, working with a natural material that I can take a tree and produce items that are going to outlive me, and the craftsmanship that's required to achieve that, that's probably the main attraction. Using only hand tools is just uneconomic. People couldn't afford to do it, although I'd quite enjoy doing it, and that's how we did start. In fact, that's one of the main reasons that we have our own sawmill, is because we couldn't get commercial sawmills to supply us with specific cuts from a tree. If we buy in timbers outside from some of the bigger timber mills, and when we request boxed heart timber, which is from the very centre of the tree, but unfortunately only one of them is any use, because it has to be the centre of the tree for a post, so it shrinks equally on all faces. We're not really a sawmiller as such. That was not what the intention was. It was a means to an end. We needed to produce timber from certain parts of the tree to certain dimensions, and that's what the only way we could do it is with a sawmill of our own. The advantage of having the Wood-Mizer moulder on the same rails as the sawmill means we never have to take that timber off the machine. We'll plane it to exactly what we want within probably half a millimetre, maybe a millimetre over a long distance. And it means it improves a lot of things. It gives us a nice surface finish for interior timbers, and also gives us an accurate, planed on all sides piece of timber that we can easily work out from what the best reference faces are going to be for traditional carpentry. I've been fortunate enough to have my sons work for me, hopefully giving them a good basis for future careers, whether they choose to stay with the business or whether they go off on their own. They now know what's involved in it all. Well, my youngest son, he served his apprenticeship with me. My other son, he works for me full time. He graduated in art and philosophy, which I was apprehensive as to where his career would go with an art and philosophy degree. But having said that, his ability to visualise things in three dimensions, you never have to tell him something twice. Plus, his abilities, his cleverness, allowed him to teach himself effectively AutoCAD. I remember I was out in Canada, and I thought I had an email from him saying I had made a mistake on a drawing that he was trying to manufacture. And I said, "Well, listen, I can't do anything about it. I'm in Canada just now." And he promptly said, "It's okay, Dad, I fixed it." And I'm thinking, "And how did you do that?" He says, "Because I watch everything you do." And he said, "I've taught myself how to do it." And that ability was quite interesting. and surprising, but very, very useful. I'm constantly looking for new ways of doing things and alternative ways of improving things. And I thought, first of all, if I could come up with some form of mechanical linking, jointing system, the simplest and most efficient way of joining these the sort of timbers that we're working with was to use this particular system here. The whole building can be assembled virtually by nothing more than this Allen key. The advantage of this product is that we can actually dismantle the product quite easily. And that was another requirement that we had, was for buildings that can be assembled temporarily and dismantled and moved. This whole connector system has proved by destructive testing, it's actually stronger than traditional mortise and tenon joints. Nothing that can be taken down easily, but this system can. The other thing that we've developed is a non-structural insulation panel, and it allows us to enclose the envelope of the building quickly. We can have different types of finish on the inside here. And the building is wind and watertight in the same day. Our buildings can be dismantled, changed into something else, reassembled. To me, that's sustainability. One of the big things we find actually is customers spend a lot of time sitting in the building, looking at the building, rather than looking out their windows.